These are the tasks that this video covers. Feel free to pause at any time to make notes. In the interest of time and clarity, this was recorded in pieces and edited, and some pieces are sped up. To record the Zorin installation, I had to use VirtualBox, but the steps are the same as I did on my netbook. First thing I did was download Zorin Lite 32-bit. It is closer to the bottom of the start page, and click Learn More. Take a look at the installation instructions on the website as well. Zorin recommends using Etcher to create the bootable installation USB. Etcher installs without prompts and starts immediately. Select the Zorin ISO and the USB drive you want to use and then click Flash. On the HP Mini 210, Escape key gets you the boot menu where you can select the USB drive. First thing after booting from the USB is a black screen with two icons at the bottom. Use the Escape key again and that will give you the options instead of booting as a live CD. Select Install Zorin and then F6 for options. Remove Quiet and Splash so we see what is happening and add ACPI equals off and PNP BIOS equals off. ACPI and PNP BIOS gives me errors in trying to install Linux on this netbook, so I disable them during boot. Feel free to select the install options that you want. I chose updates during install and disk encryption among other things. Screen may go blank while copying files or installing. Simply move the mouse to wake it up. Now you are required to restart. Get ready to press Escape on restart to get to the boot options. Select E to edit and same as before, I turned off ACPI, PNP BIOS, Splash and Quiet mode. Look for the line that starts with Linux. During boot, you will be prompted for disk encryption password. Now let's look at some actual screenshots from the netbook. Beautiful and clean graphics. Here are the settings. This is CPU and memory use without any apps running. Start menu and OS info. Thanks for watching. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And connect from hasantt.com.